Okay, so we're going to make a salad smoothie here. We're going to have a generous helping here on the left, you can see, of organic mixed greens. That's actually about 5 ounces, maybe a little bit north of 5 ounces of salad mixed greens. And then we're going to have also an organic Granny Smith apple. And then also we're going to have some blueberries, just a little handful of blueberries, and also some blackberries. You can also substitute the blackberries for raspberries, which I think actually tastes better, but we don't have any today, at least not in the refrigerator. So those are the ingredients, along with 8 ounces of water and 5 ice cubes, for our salad smoothie. So let's get to work. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to actually wash the berries and the apple that we're going to use in the smoothie. I like to use veggie wash as sort of the cleaning agent for the fruits and vegetables. This gets off any residual waxes, any herbicides or insecticides that may be lingering on the fruit if it's not organic. And in this case, the apple is organic, however, the berries are not. So once we get fruits thoroughly washed, we're then going to take the seeds out of the apple. Obviously, apples have seeds towards the core, and seeds have nutrients within them, and those nutrients are really designed to help the fruit or the seed actually spontaneously begin its growth process. However, some seeds, not all, some have anti-nutrients in them, and those anti-nutrients are there to act as, for example, a natural insecticide to keep bugs and pests away, or an antifungal, or an antiviral. And some seeds have fairly strong properties that are anti-nutritional. And apples happen to be one that are somewhere in the middle of that spectrum. A peach, for example, would have a high content of anti-nutrients, and you definitely want to avoid a peach pit. Not that you'd eat one, but apple seeds are somewhere in the middle. So we're going to go ahead and core this, and I'll show you the results of doing just that. Hold on. Okay, what I've done here is I've actually taken the apple and I initially cut it into quarters. That exposed the core as well as most of the seeds, and I really just took the French chef's knife and I took the point of it and I dug some of the seeds out. Most of them were actually just on the surface, and I was able to just slide them off with the blade of the knife. But then I actually did go ahead and cut them again, so now we have eighths, and there were some seeds that were hiding in the middle of the core, but I haven't really actually decored the apple. The core is really still in there. A lot of good nutrients in that part of the apple that we didn't want to throw away. It's also kind of wasteful too, so we get the whole entire apple this way, just minus the seeds. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and get our blender container and put 8 ounces of cold water into it. Okay, with 8 ounces of cold water in our blender, what we're going to do is first put in the berries. Those will go into the cold water. We'll then take our salad greens, our mixed greens, and we'll start to place those in the container next. You really kind of want to pack them down in there a little bit, not too hard, but just a little bit, so that when you turn the blender on, the blades actually catch some of the lettuce leaves and pull them down into the blades. That's the way this blender works. It kind of pulls things down into it. This is a Blendtec. A Vitamix is also another good blender to use. They're more along the professional lines of blending and are extremely powerful. You can use a regular blender that you'd buy at the store, but your results may be a little bit different. So now what we're going to do is take the apples and put those apples on top. All right, and now for some ice cubes. We'll put about 4 to 5 ice cubes. And the reason that we put the ice cube in is really just to give it a little bit chilliness, kind of cools the drink down a little bit. You don't have to put the ice cubes in if you don't want. Many times I just skip ice cubes, but on a warmer day I'll put some ice cubes in. So that's what we're going to do next. We'll put those on, put those into the blender container, and then we'll go ahead and blend it up and we'll show you the results. Okay, so you can see what we have here on the bottom. We have our water, with our berries. And then on top of that, we have our 5 to 6 ounces of mixed greens that we've kind of packed down in there a little bit. And then on top of that, we have our entire Granny Smith apple. And then we have 4 or 5 ice cubes on the top just to chill it down a little bit. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit the blend button on the BlendTec and let it go. And you can kind of see what'll happen. I'm gonna stop it actually, just so you know. The BlendTec cycle is a little bit long, and I like for the output of this to be a little bit on the thicker side or the chunkier side, as opposed to just having a real soupy mix. So I like there to be a little bit of texture to it. So I'm going to stop the BlendTec cycle a little bit before it's finished. So with that having been said, let's go ahead and start it up. It a little bit, make sure sometimes there's some apple that stays in larger chunks. All so the color is going to be a little bit unappetizing. I'm not gonna kid you. It's kind of brown in this case. When you do raspberries, it's a little red, but this is actually the finished product. You can see there's a lot of speckles from the berries that are in there. But I gotta tell you, that apple, which is kind of a tart apple, the Granny Smith is, and then the bitter sort of leaf that's in there from the mixed greens, and then a little bit of sweetness from the blueberries gives it a pretty darn good taste. It's not like a chocolate milkshake, but it does taste good, and I'll tell you what, it really is amazing how good it makes you feel when you finish this. And I actually drink the entire amount. It makes enough for two. I typically drink both servings myself. It takes me about 10 minutes to do that, and I definitely do feel better afterwards. So hopefully when you try this, you'll feel better too.